Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
The first Red Dead Redemption game released in 2010 on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360, and despite all of the success it has achieved, being one of the highest rated games of all time and reaching 23 million units sold as of 2021, it still hasn't been ported to any other platform. However, there are two ways of playing this game on PC right now, and in this video we're gonna take a look and compare them. So let's get started.
Even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
The first option we're going to look at is running the PlayStation 3 version of Red Dead Redemption on RPCS3, the PlayStation 3 emulator.
Right now! Go away now, John! Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill!
If you're familiar with PS3 emulation, you know that the cell, the PS3's processor, is quite hard to emulate. Which means that certain games that make good use of the CPU are very heavy to run on the RPCS3 emulator. And unfortunately, Red Dead Redemption is one of these games. On my i5-9600K, the game is basically unplayable, sometimes dropping to almost 10 FPS. In this footage, the game is running at the native resolution it runs on PS3, which is 640p. But even if I change the resolution to 4K, the performance doesn't change that much. That's because the performance is limited by the CPU, and my GPU, which is an RTX 2060 Super, is enough to run this game at 4K on RPCS3. Still, for those that have very powerful CPUs, RPCS3 can run this game at 4K 60fps with no major problems. The only issue I've seen is that the character models seem to render incorrectly at a certain distance. If you have a powerful CPU and want to run this game at a frame rate higher than 30fps, you should increase the V-blank setting to something like 240Hz. And if you want to try running at higher than 60fps, there's a patch that enables that as well, but you will need a very powerful CPU, like a 13900K. Anyway, here are the settings I've used. So, while it's hard to run, if you have a very strong PC, RPCS3 is a good option to play Red Dead Redemption on PC. But there is another option, which has some differences.
You must be John Marston.
Sometimes.
The other option is running the Xbox 360 version of Red Dead Redemption on Xenia, the Xbox 360 emulator.
You getting cute with me, boy?
What's going on here?
I got me one of them Williamson boys.
I got me one of them idiots who give marshals a bad name.
The good news is that Xenia is quite easier on the CPU compared to RPCS3. As you can see in the footage, my 9600K was capable of running Red Dead Redemption on Xenia at 60fps with no problems at 720p. However, when it comes to increasing the resolution, Xenia becomes quite heavy on the GPU, unfortunately. Unlike on RPCS3, my RTX 2060 Super was not powerful enough to run this game at a playable frame rate in 4K. Even in 1440p, it would only reach around 30fps in cutscenes. Still, the game runs much more smoothly when it's GPU limited compared to when it's CPU limited on RPCS3. So even at 1440p 30fps, the game is quite enjoyable. Also, if your GPU is having trouble even at the native Xbox resolution of 720p, if you use Xenia Canary version, There are patches available that make the game run at lower resolutions like 540, 480, or even 360p. So in terms of performance, Xenia is much more accessible than RPCS3. Additionally, the Xbox 360 version had a few graphical differences compared to the PS3 version, such as slightly higher texture resolution on Xbox. Better dynamic lighting.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
And sharper shadows.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
Although I personally prefer the softer shadows on PS3. What do you think? Tell me in the comments below.
I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Xenia unfortunately has a couple of visual bugs with this game though. The first one is the lens flare, which always renders, even when you're indoors, although you can disable this effect with the cannery patch. And the other one is the flickering that happens sometimes on indoor shadows.
You must be John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to get...
However, these are minor issues. On the other hand, when you unlock the frame rate up to 60 FPS, or more if you use a patch, similarly to RPCS3, you can experience some significant issues. The ones I've seen were some parts of a cutscene going out of sync, and one cutscene having no audio.
Oh, hardy fucking whore, dickhead.
These are major issues that ruin the experience, in my opinion. So if you experience any of these, I recommend capping the FPS at 30, like in the original consoles. And here are the only settings that change from default. So, after looking at these options, we end up with two opposing situations. On one hand, RPCS3 is very heavy on the CPU, but has less glitches. On the other hand, Xenia is much more accessible, becoming GPU heavy only at high resolutions. But it has more glitches, including possibly game-breaking ones. So what is the best option? If you have a very strong CPU, I'd recommend RPCS3. Like mentioned before, it has fewer glitches. And as a bonus, you can even play online multiplayer on it. However, if your CPU isn't that powerful, you're better off with Xenia. It's still a great experience, with slightly better graphics. So, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe for more. If you want to get in touch with me, I've created a Twitter account so you can follow me there. Also, if you have any suggestions for other games I can make these types of videos on, let me know in the comments or on Twitter. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.